All right, hey everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome back to... that was a weird spike. Welcome back to Scrap Mechanic. I'm still alone. That's fine. What are we gonna make today? Hell if I know. All right, first and foremost, I'm gonna reset my inventory. There we go. Okay, so now I can pull up my inventory with tab instead of reaching over for I. Actually, we got a launch pad over here. Let's head for that. So, I don't know what to do with myself today. Hold the phone. I might know what to do with myself today. Let's go to the launch pad while I think of how the hell I'm going to design this. Do we have the blocks? Could I make this? I could. Okay. Let's get started. I'm gonna make something stupid. Let's grab our light blocks and let's make a little 3x3, right? Yeah, 3x3 probably seems like a good idea. In fact, you know, hold on. This might be faster if I did it. Can I do it a different way? I don't know. Let me pull something out for reference. Okay, so assuming that Durf can make this, I can probably make what I need to make. Okay. Is this going to be small enough? Do we want to make it bigger? I want to make a car that turns into a ball, like this, and then rolls away. Is it going to work? Hell no. But it could be fun. Could be really fun. Alright, let's grab some light blocks. We need, what do we need? We need three types of blocks here. We need this kind. This kind. And this kind. And that should do the trick. I guess I'll have it even? I don't know. I don't really know what the plan here is yet. Yeah, we need it even. Okay, hold on. Hold horses. So we're gonna delete all but one section of this. So it's going to be four blocks. Okay, here we go. So I gotta figure out how to get wheels onto this sucker. Hell, I have to figure out this whole thing. I really, really do not have a whole lot of hope that this is going to work. But I'm really interested in finding out. Because we made the, giant shark thing. Or not shark, well, I guess it did have kind of a shark's mouth to it, but that, like, flying pyramid. So I can do that. It's just a matter of getting this thing to transform in a believable way. That also doesn't suck. So I'm thinking of making, a dome, effectively. Two parts. Top and bottom. Bottom unfolds. Top part stays the same, just because I don't know what I'd do with the upper part apart from having it fold out slightly. Because my alternatives are limited. Interesting. Okay. Now, the one problem is I really don't want to make this much bigger than this for a couple of reasons. One, just because it would become unmanageable. Oops. Wasn't supposed to do that. I was like, why does this suddenly make a lot less sense to me? Okay. There we go. Yeah, we don't want to make this too big. I might have to add another layer here. I guess as long as it can be split up into a couple of parts, it doesn't really matter how small I make it, but I don't want it to be, like, ridiculously large. Okay, yeah, we're gonna need another section here. I might be able to delete some of these side blocks, but I'm not entirely sure. Okay. So now it's odd wide, but that's okay. Because I can work with this. The other thing I could potentially do might get messed up. Nope, it's not going to get messed up. As long as it's attached to the base and I don't delete any blocks, we're good. This gives me a lot more room and lightens the load a bunch. Okay. So I have 4 of these. Now, are we good? Do we want to make it any bigger, smaller, anything? Because it's... it's probably fine. Now, how did we get the wheels in here? Actually, the wheels are probably the easiest. Let's figure out the mechanism to get this thing to unfold. So I'm going to put a block here. Yeah. Okay. Because I was starting to actually work on something like this for the original, for my original flying pyramid. But it, I'm not going to say it backfired, but it just, it didn't really do what I wanted it to do. Which was a bit of a disappointment. Or mainly, I just didn't feel like programming it at the time. I think both Bird and I were tired that day. Anyway, so if we do something like this, and it comes out a bunch. So this way I can have it raise and lower. I guess if I have the... Oh. No, that's not gonna work. I almost feel like I'm gonna have to do the same thing with the tire in here and have it, like, unfurl somehow. Because there's no way I can have a tire that sits slightly out of this thing unless I have it, like, flip around somehow. But I'm... Also, I just realized I'm actually going to have it be like this. But this is going to work because it's almost immediately going to have to attach to the other one. Okay. So I'm going to have to move this over one. And then this. And then we have the central platform here. Wow, this thing is going to be a piece of garbage. Either I'm going to have to make it a lot larger, or, yeah, where do I even fit the wheel in on this? And how do I get these things to split apart properly? Well, okay, no, we have some options here. Okay, because if I do... if I do this, let's save it as, I don't know, ball car quarter or something. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to dupe the design wrong? Maybe, maybe not. All right, let's grab this. We don't need the engine right now. If I do that, put this on a lift, grab the welding tool. Yeah. Not going to work the way I wanted it to. That's okay. I'm just going to extend it there. Okay. Shoot. Alright, so initial tests show that I'm a dumbass. Let's try that again. There we go. Okay, so now it's at least remotely connected to the right way. Oh, but I'm still a dumbass. All right. I just realized I don't have a bearing in here. which is arguably one of the more important bearings. I guess we delete this whole thing. Start over. Well, that's fine. Measure never, cut always. Alright. I don't know if I need another bearing in there, so I'm probably going to ignore that for the time being. Alright. There we go. Probably should have named it anyway. Ball car quarter, replace, and let's make another one. Okay, so this one's gonna have this here, and then we're gonna weld this down there. Okay, perfect. So I'll need more ball car quarters. Problem is, we're gonna have to delete the, Yeah, we're gonna have to delete this whole setup and mimic a second time. Huh. Interesting, I didn't realize that was the only thing keeping it down. I guess they are just light blocks for the time being. Okay, but yeah, we want to mimic the same thing on this side. Oh, wait, no. But we want it to... We want it to run this way. Maybe I was doing something wrong. And my dwarfy ass is in the wrong way. Okay, perfect. Okay, we really, really need some kind of sorting for this, please. Okay, there we go. Okay, yeah, this thing's gonna break. That's probably fine, but... Oh, what? Oh. I see why that was wrong. It's a spare piece, I guess. And that's not going to connect for some reason, so I guess... Let's try this again. Okay, here we go. Still got a... not going to connect. That's disconcerting. Okay. Let's try building it out a little bit. Oh, you know what? No. Instead of building it out a little bit, let's just cut off the really easy parts. Because if we cut off these ramps... Maybe this will let us weld it down real quick. Unfortunately, this is here now. Okay, there we go. There we go. I figured this would probably be the easiest way to fix the problem. Yeah, because this way it's just ramps. So all I have to do is just make sure they're attached properly. And there we go. Unfortunately, I'm probably going to have to tear this whole thing up. In fact, this entire episode might just end in abject failure, but that's okay. Alright, so we've got this set up. Let's figure out. So, I guess we do have space for a controller and some other things on here. I guess I don't need these anymore. I'm gonna need two controllers. Fair enough. I'll just throw them both on. Okay. Yeah, the biggest issue I'm looking at right now is I think it needs to double back. So if maybe if I had it go forward, back, and this way. Because right now what happens is... 3 and 6 need to go 90. The biggest problem is it doesn't expand out. Which is kind of what we need it to do. Which is rough. Cause yeah, I'm just gonna slap this down. Well, this is full of hilarious consequences. Yeah, because this ain't gonna work. Yeah, so the biggest problem is this actually comes kind of close. I mean, obviously we have several issues that we're looking at here. I mean, so here's the thing. I could have a wheel in here, but it wouldn't do much. If I could get this thing to walk, it would actually look awesome. But yeah, we need to work on our unfolding mechanism a lot. So I'm pretty much going to have to cut off every bit here and start over. Well, I guess the easiest way to do it would actually be to move on. And take a look. Okay. Okay. So we need more rotation, and we need it to actually unfold. Nice thing is, we didn't actually even need that block in here. Oops. There we go. Okay, so let's consider. Let's throw on some blocks. This is going to be a multi-part ordeal. Either that or I give up after a certain point. Not entirely sure. Anyway. I guess the easiest thing for me to do would actually be to have it loop back and forth a couple of times here in this space. Yeah, why don't we do that for a second? I'm just trying to decide, do we have enough room for it to do this? I guess if we went up for the last one. Yeah, let me try a couple of things. So if I do this, and then this, and then we loop the rest of the way. Actually, this could work even better. Because this gives me a hell of a lot more room to work with, internally. Okay, let's make an ultra-heavy, like, armature or something. This is good Metal Gear Solid remix. Really need to play Metal Gear Solid on the channel someday. Someday. Maybe when I live near Keith or something. Okay. So, what this will do is kind of exactly what I was hoping it would do. It'll noodle out properly. Gives me a lot more room. Let's grab a controller and just kind of mess with the animation for a bit. Really need more space on this bar. Okay, here we go. So let's have one and two go out 180. It's probably going to topple the whole structure, but that's okay. Okay. So we do that. And then we do just 90. Alright. So the biggest issue is actually kind of easily solved. Let me see this for a second. So I'm looking at this now. We've actually got a really good setup here. We just need an extra two bearings. One here and one there. And that way I can have them rotate out 45 degrees without major issues. And then we can have a tire hidden somewhere in here. It might even have to unfold. Or it might actually have to be two tires or something just for stability's sake. We'll figure that out in a second. Either way. Fuck the ceramics. Okay. So we're gonna do that. And then we're gonna do this. Oh, right. We need another remix here. Okay. There we go. So this might be a little bit cramped. We might have to make this thing bigger. Just to fit everything. Well, no, because we're going to have a lot of top space to work with here. I don't know. We might be okay. All right, let's get rid of these things. Let's slap this back on. That'll be fine. Okay. No bearings connected. That's fine. 2, 3. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. 45, 45. Oh, whoops. I was supposed to set that as default. Whatever. We're not using these ramp blocks for the time being. Hook it up, and wham. Alright, so a couple of issues. One. There we go. Two. Alright. It's not perfect and it looks a little wonky, but it actually works. I'm halfway tempted to have these things expand out a little bit further, but I don't think I want to do that. Now, if we do want to have a tire in here, let's see. Where is there room for a tire? Not much room for a tire. There's room for a tire, like, right here. Now, obviously, this isn't gonna last. But there is room for a tire in there, and I could probably fit a mechanism to get it to unfurl right here. So let's try that. We need a bearing, of course. So, if I just had something like this, okay, that also fits. We just need to have 6 unfurl at the exact same time. Possibly even before. That'd be risky. Alright. So it looks a little goofy, having the tires stick out like that. I kind of don't enjoy that. And also looks like... No, it's not at an angle, it's just too tall. Okay. So that's not a big deal. The interesting point is, I've actually got this rotating right and wrong at the same time. It fits. We just, yeah, all right. Start cutting bits off and let's get this thing to work. Unfortunately, we're gonna have to get a new controller up in here, but that's okay. Yeah, it looks like it fits. The only problem is I'm going to have to redo this entire tire system. Effectively backwards. Which isn't great. Alright, let's put this ultra heavy thing here. And let's figure out what I can do. So for starters, we need a controller in here. I'm going to go with the small purplish ones. Mainly just so I don't have to worry about it again. There really needs to be like a mirror mode. It'd be so nice. Okay, put this here, put this here. I think we're good. Okay, so... so let's save this as ball car quarter. I'll fix it up and paint it for later. Okay, so easy option. Let's just go down the list instead this time. There we go. And last bearing is the wheel, which we don't want to truck with. So 180, 45, 180, 45, 90, 180. Okay. Right. Needs to be hooked up to a switch. Well, we'll do that in a second. I guess next dealio is... I'll save it as ball car quarter again. There'd be a way to switch the ramps on this. No. Not really. Okay. I'm just gonna weld this here. We might as well start with the two available quarters and go from there. Unfortunately, I can never get on this thing. At least not initially. Alright. Let's put that there. It's not gonna last, but that's okay. Unfortunately, I have to recreate the whole ball car quarter thing a second time, going the opposite direction. Just so it actually fits, which is kind of wildly inconvenient. Okay, yeah, I guess I'll just start by cutting everything off. I mean, luckily I can copy and paste almost everything. So that bit's nice. It'd just be so nice if there's like a mirror mode that you could enable for all vehicles in this game. Okay, so how the hell did I do this again? I'm trying to rotate my brain. So it's still coming off of this internal corner. So we still need this. I'm not even sure if I actually like how this thing unfolds right now. I just want something that unfolds, period. I guess. Okay, so it goes... this up over needs a bearing in both. And then back again. And then up bearing over bearing this. Okay. Awesome. How the hell did I get the wheel in, too? The wheel's actually, like, stupid simple. Because we do this. 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 Bearing. This. Yes? Looks like it. Okay. Okay, Ball Carl. That's a dumb name. Alright. And this should weld on, no problem. Alright. And we're gonna do this one more time. That's some lag. It'll be done soon, and luckily we don't have multiplayer people to complain about it. Alright. As per last time, one of these... oops. Is causing issues. just hope I don't have to rebuild it. And I don't have somebody here to put a lift down for me. Oh, the biggest offender is actually just the tire here, yes? Okay, I can rebuild that. I have the technology for that. I'm a little bit worried about the pipe segments, though. Let's just hope those aren't the ones colliding. Oh, wait. What if we put this on a lift? Maybe that'll solve the problem. Like, there might be a little bit of saggage going on. And that's messing with me. Shoot. I ran into the same problem last time, too. Alright. Let's isolate the issue. If I can, maybe? Because it could also be the lift somehow. Okay. Let's cut that off. The less we have colliding, generally the better. Alright, fine. I guess I'll have to do this the really hard way. Actually, I mean, honestly, this isn't so bad. It's just kind of frustrating. Because there's a very real possibility I'm going to end up deleting half of this anyway. And I hate to waste all of my time just because welding is an issue. Well, I don't know. Figure it out. Okay, so how does it do the final section? It's just a bearing goes this way, correct? No, other way. Okay. Blank this off. Should be up. Nope. Gotta get this on a lift. Gotta get this up a little bit. Okay. Let's try this. Son of a bitch. I don't know what's wrong. Alright, let's try not welding on a bearing, because that never goes well. Oh. That would actually be one option. I haven't tried yet. There might be an easy-ish solution for this. Yeah, okay. Easy-ish solution. It is. Okay. Why? Oh, these aren't connected. Alright, whatever. It's an easy fix. Okay, so 180, 45. That should work, right? Yes. It better. Could be wrong. Okay, honestly, I guess I'm gonna have to do the same thing here. This won't take too long. Let's get rid of these blocks. They're not helping in any way. Ah, and we need one switch. Which I can actually hide in kind of anywhere. I guess I'll toss there for the time being. Delete that. Flip the switch. Watch as this thing flips its shit. Alright. Let's set it on very slow for all of them. That way we can diagnose what the hell's going wrong. And if it does flip out again, it's less of an issue. Okay. That did not help. I need to focus on, I think, one at a time. Okay. You need to be that way. Okay. Fine. So that's correct. This is not. This is definitely not. I don't know about the last one. Oh my god, this is horrifying. I really should have done this beforehand. Okay. Well, you're rotating wrong. You're rotating wrong. I'll fix the easy ones first, I think. That'll make this easier. I am trapped. I'm not trapped. Okay. So what's wrong with these? This is rotated wrong. Or it's programmed wrong. Okay. So 2 and 4 are wrong. Yes? No. 45. Ah. Okay. So 5 is also wrong. 5 is set at 180. 5 is 90. Oh. Okay. This is at 180. This is at 90. Okay. It's working a little bit better than I intended. I had assumed. Okay. Now what the hell's wrong with you? The answer is everything. Alright, so for starters, actually, strangely enough, it feels like the back one shouldn't be messed up. Okay. Watching this thing transform is horrifying. I think I might have to rethink all of this programming. Well, we've got a bunch of controllers here. So let's disconnect everything. I'm gonna have each animation associated with different controllers. That'll probably make my life a lot easier. And this way I can diagnose what's going on. Because this is currently just a chaotic mess, and that's no good. Okay, so what has to happen first is these. Uh-oh. Okay, so we want to do 2. Okay, there we go. So we want all of these to go 180. if I'm not mistaken. Okay, and they're going 180 positive. Well, let's take it off the lift. Okay. Let's back up a bit more. Let's get rid of most of these. And also remember to connect everything else to the other controllers. Because I just realized this is going to be a problem otherwise. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Nope. 6, 7, 8. Well, it's going to make it a lot easier getting all of these things. Because it's kind of coordinated really easily. Okay, and then the remaining one will be for later. I guess, no, let's do it now. Oops. There. Okay,